Welcome back. I'm MTG Joe, and we're going to be firing up our next installment in the budget build series for blue-green or Simic Flash. So this is the mid-budget version. For those of you who are unfamiliar with what we do on this build series, is we start off with a deck that's basically all commons and uncommons. From there, what we do is we transition into a mid-budget variant that is about 10 to 12 mythic and rare wildcards combined. And then we transition into a fully tuned version of the deck. Generally speaking, this is a three-color variant. We try to drop any budget constraints. One note with all versions is we do play, at minimum, the pairing of shocklands and checklands, just to have a good enough mana base that we can demonstrate what the deck is hoping to achieve. These can always be substituted with tap lands or basics if you are in a crunch. When it comes to blue-green flash, the mid-budget version is pretty much the deck that's being really popular right now in terms of ranked play as well as MTGO results. So the deck itself is basically looking to play spells on your opponent's turn. Everything in the main board can be played on the opponent's turn. So what we do is we try to drop early creatures in the form of Spectral Sailor, Brineborn Cutthroat, which gets bigger when we play stuff on our opponent's turn, Merfolk Trickster to screw up the opponent's attacks or tap down attackers. We then have disruption in the form of a number of counter spells in terms of Syncopate, Essence Scatter, Negate, and Sinister Sabotage. We also then have Unsummon that can be used to bounce our own creatures or bounce our opponents, Opt as a card draw spell to round things up, and then we have Frilled Mystic as a counter spell. The two rares we're adding to this deck are Nightpack Ambusher. This is the best card in the deck. It's a 4-4 that creates 3-3s basically every turn. It's really what helps close out the game fairly quickly. And then I'm trying out Awakening of Vitu-Ghazi. So this was something that's played in a lot of lists. It's just a fast way of closing out the game when you have a 9-9 land. And then just in terms of the mana base, we're adding 3 Temples of Mystery. Just to be a little bit more consistent in our mana, as well as filtering our draws through the scry. As I mentioned with the other video, I don't have a Hinterland Harbor for the full set. With rotation coming, I'm just opting not to craft it. So it's a good demo to see if you don't have the cards, how it plays out. Generally speaking, I'm fine with this type of mana base. The sideboard itself really is only adding Shifting Ceratops, which is a really good card in the meta right now. It's a big body, can deal with like Nexus. Can deal with like Teferis, stuff like that. And then we have our Aether Gust versus like the Gruul-based Dino matchups, Drakes versus Red-based decks, Negates, and some Brontodons versus Nexus. So this is actually the second time I've recorded the video. Had some issues with the client. I was playing Frank Leopore, actually, from Channel Fireball, and we were having a really good match on his stream as well. But my video got corrupted, so playing it again. I'm going to play 1-2 games in ranked best of 3, and then 1-2 games in ranked best of 1, depending on how long the games play out. So we'll get started. So as we get started, as mentioned in past videos, a quick favor to ask if you can. If you can subscribe to the channel, a little button in the bottom right-hand corner. It's free and easy way to support the channel, costs you absolutely nothing, and helps me basically get YouTube to subsidize some of the cards that I have to purchase for all these build series. Not looking to make a fortune off this or a full-time job, just trying to not pay everything out of pocket would be greatly appreciated, and that helps keep ads off the channel in terms of like banners and stuff like that. So we'll play first. This hand's a bit slow, we don't have an early threat, and Syncopate's not the most consistent counter spell, so probably mulligan this. Okay, I like this hand a bit better. We have Unsummons for early tempo. I'm going to put back the Awakening. I don't think we're at that point yet. So I'm just going to play the Island here. Gives out less information. Okay, so this is mono red. So just from a tempo standpoint, I want to bounce this. So hopefully we draw some lands. We're going to play Brineborn down next turn, and then we can unsummon their creature if need be. could screw up some of their blocks as well. So opponent might be missing lands, which is good for us. So really wanted to hit a land there. We're just going to pass the turn here. So no blocks here. We don't really have a target for Unsummon. See what they drop here. Light up the stage is a little unfortunate. So they'll probably play the Lava Runner here. So here, the Lava Runner could have haste if they have another spell. I still think we just do that. Okay, so we can sabotage it when it comes down if they have a removal spell. I think I'm fine there. We want to counter whatever's going to try to target Brineborn. Okay, so we will block here. See if they play an effect. So here we're just, it's a way to protect it. If they want to use like a shock, they can. Yeah, so that burned a couple spells out of their hand. Perfect. So this ensures we can play a Frilled Mystic next turn. We're not going to take the block this turn, so we'll take 2 points of damage. That's probably fine enough to block, because then it makes it so they have to trade or burn another spell to get rid of the Mystic. Okay. So they've used quite a few spells here. Okay. So them chaining together light up the stage is a little unfortunate. We're going to take the hit and then counter the light up the stage. Because they can trigger Spectacle regardless here. See if they have any subsequent plays. So they've pointed a lot of burn at our creatures. I think they've gone through, so how many light up the stage? 3 light up the stage, which has given them a lot of kind of staying power. Mono red's a tough matchup because they can usually get under our counter spells. I think we just take it. Without us drawing, like, counter that. What's his name? The 1/1 pirate that draws cards. We're kind of falling behind in this game. Okay. We're not going to catch up against Chandra here. Okay, so I usually like Brontodons in this matchup, the Cerulean Drakes. They'll generally bring in... like stuff we want to block with that. I usually cut a couple Sabotage. The Awakening's not good. Syncopate's going to be a little slow. Probably get rid of the Negates. And then, because Aether Gust can basically deal with stuff once it's there, but also get it off the stack. Probably cut down an Essence Scatter and another Sabotage. Because we really just want to keep the creatures off the board. Planeswalkers we can attack in. Brontodon's just a good blocker and has the upside of hitting Experimental Frenzy. This matchup, they probably won't bring in Tybalt. 3 mana Chandra's pretty annoying. We'll keep this. If they have an early creature drop, we can play Cerulean Drake to buy us time until we can get Nightpack Ambusher down. I think we just play it safe there. Okay. This will keep our life total fairly high. We can just keep blocking their creatures. Okay, no attacks by the opponent is good. Just pass the turn. Hopefully they run out another creature here. They don't. So now we're in a really good spot. I'm probably not gonna play out the Ambusher just yet until we have a spell to protect it, because it's not unlikely they have some sort of 3 damage plus the Firebrand. We can play Trickster and start attacking in. All right, so opponent cannot beat a Drake. We'll run it back here. I might do a split with Negate. Just maybe play another Sabotage. We have a lot in the 2-drop slot. Because there, like, I wanted to protect Nightpack Ambusher. And with them on the play, I'm less likely to catch a creature. Most of their non-creature spells will come after they've already deployed creatures, whether it be the Spectacle stuff or a Planeswalker. We'll keep this hand. Alright, so we got a few options here. Let's slow them down a bit. With these lists playing less Wizard's Lightning because of Chandra's Spitfire, you're less inclined to do this while they still have open mana. Here, let's just drop the Drake. So really we just want lands now. We have Trickster that can ambush as well. Okay, so they shock here. Probably to turn on Light Up the Stage, perhaps. Okay, for Skewer. Okay. So they've gone through a lot of their cards. Okay, that is good. We'll pass the turn. So I'm doing this because I want to start attacking in. And if they want to... Okay, that's fine. That's two damage that's not coming to our face. Now we have the Ambusher this turn. And that should be allow us to close out the game pretty quick. Yep. Opponent has lost all faith in his ability to beat our 1-1 Dirtle. Grab our coins for the day. So I'll probably play just let me play a best of one. It'll give you some ideas. Sideboarding's not too much with this deck. Like, you're basically just shoring up certain matchups, like you saw there, like mono red, we brought it in. I might be able to play a bit more variety in the best of one. We'll keep this. For the non-budget version, or like the next variant, I'm going to be playing Sultai. So adding in black for some more targeted removal. I'm okay with the land here. I want to hit my land drops. Temple of Epiphany can be... Oh, so Grixis. Alright. Should be okay against Grixis. Like, they'll have a lot of removal. But the fact we can interact with a lot of their threats. My one concern is they do have an opening here. Oh, that's perfect. So they can't drop Nicol Bolas here. We have a counter for it, and then we can go straight into Nightpack Ambusher or Frilled Mystics. That's fine. We really just want to protect this turn, because this is the turn that we're exposed. Yeah. I don't want Spectral Sailor right now. I want either something that interacts with their board or is a counterspell. I think Thought Erasure's enough to warrant that. Okay. I'll keep Syncopate. It's a way we can potentially protect the Ambusher. So I'm going to do these instead of the Ambusher because it puts them on a good clock. And it's two threats versus one. 4 open mana at a Grixis usually means some removal. They might be playing Cryocarnarium. I think we just do this. It increases the clock. So now they have to kill the Frilled Mystic. Yeah, we got him there. Sweet. Claim the prize there. Play one more. So with the next build series, I think I'm going to do black-white life gain. With Vampires, it's a popular deck right now, but I'm hesitant to really suggest people build it if you don't already have the cards, just because so much of the deck gets hit by rotation. There are some interesting cards with like a Johnny's Pride Maid and some other cards that we can explore in that sense. So mulligan this hand. I can't recall if I'm playing unranked or if I'm playing ranked. think we just bought the Unsummon. Rugged Highland can be budget constraints. It can be some of the Scapeshift decks. Yeah, so it's budget Naya Feather. So, kind of wish we kept that Unsummon now. So we'll resolve. Gonna tap down one of them. No attacks here. So then blowing the ambush there instead of on the alpha, or the, I keep calling this Nightpack Alpha. Just pass the turn. This generally can be a tough matchup because they do have hasty threats that get quite large. Pass the turn here. So your power is that. Yeah, I think we just let it resolve. Ooh, Awakening's kind of cool. Oh, so that doesn't come untapped. Good to know. It doesn't untap a land, it just puts it on. So we can't use it defensively right now unless we have six lands. So a block like this. This makes our wolves bigger. So that was a solid trade for us. I think I'm gonna attack in with both. If they want a double block, I'm fine with doing so. Whenever you cast any of that target's creature you control, so it's on cast, so the counter doesn't matter. So we have a lot of power, and this should close out the game pretty quick. I love this card. Can I see what the card is? Gain two life. Okay, so target creature gets +2/+2. You gain two life. Does that change the math enough? Okay, just resolve. We'll counter this because this has haste anyways, so then we can just surprise them and attack them for 9. Yeah, got him. So some really good games of the deck. This is one of my favorite decks to play in the format right now, and I'm interested to explore with the Sultai variant how it goes. If you enjoyed the content, drop a comment below or make sure to subscribe. I'll be doing the Sultai version in the full write-up on Reddit, so if you want to check that out, it'll be up probably tomorrow, if not by the weekend of July 20th. Thanks for those who tuned in. Have a great one, and happy FNM to those going tomorrow.